Fall is here, hear the yell. Back to school, ring the bell. Brand new shoes, walking blues. Climb the fence, books and pens. I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
So, yes, I can as a dad myself, I can boldly say that we are on the eve of, and in some cases have already entered into, the absolute greatest time of year, school year, where we get to maybe return back to our schedules a little bit. And if you're like me, you appreciate that. But I also appreciate that we're on the eve, or in some cases into, the school year. And I appreciate it because of the opportunity to watch our kids grow and become more fully who it is that the Holy Spirit is guiding them into being. So as our school years begin at this point, we gather together to lift up our students, our teachers, our school districts, all of the things that have to do with school that are upon our hearts this morning. We begin with considering our students. Let us pray. Loving God, you are all about fresh starts, and you're even about new beginnings, resurrection. As we think of ourselves and where we are at in this time of the year, as we consider our big feelings and those big backpacks that rest on the backs of students, we ask that you would go with us. We ask that in our backpacks we may carry blank pages, sharpened pencils, and even pointy crayons. We ask that in our hearts, where we carry these big feelings and where these unanswered questions can sort of weigh upon us, that you would give us your peace. Gracious God, help us to be filled with your Spirit and live into our hopeful expectations. There are endless possibilities of what might this new year bring to our world, to our schools, to our communities, and even to ourselves. We're on the brink of what we might learn and who we might meet and who we might become. We know, gracious God, that you are our friend and you are always with us and that you keep us through it all. And so we ask that you would be with us as we ride buses and cars, as we walk, as we buckle seat belts and zip up jackets and tie on our shoes. However it happens and however we get there, whatever it is that we're wearing, we ask that you would bless this journey of the school year and that you would guide us into something new and holy and fulfilling. For even grown-ups who themselves go back to school, we ask that you would be God with us, Emmanuel, and with them too. We thank you for our teachers, for helpers, for caregivers, and leaders of all kinds, for all they do to contribute to this system and this community in which we learn. God, you are our friend who is full of wonder, and we ask that you would fill our hearts and that you would bless our hands where we interact with students. We ask that you would guide and keep them, and that this indeed would be a school year in which they grow and deepen. We ask all of this in the name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Now, as I mentioned, students and going back to school as a student isn't the totality of this experience. Some of us go back to work. Not that we ever really leave work, but maybe the summer is over and we head back into school as our vocation, as teachers or staff or faculty or administrators. And in doing that, we hope to live out God's call for our lives. Where people do this as a career, the challenges can be complex and manifold, and so we say a prayer for them at this time. Let us pray. Loving God, this morning we say a special prayer for parents, as they too are at the start of a new school year. It's always another leap of faith when our kids go on. And so we ask that you would wrap us as parents in your reassuring love, and that you would help us as we entrust our children and as we trust in you. Where there are questions and where they are unanswered, where the realm of our own control is finite, we ask that you would bless us with peace and the promise that you are right there with our children. And we ask that you would remind us that no matter how old they are, you are God. We pray for teachers, for staff, for administrators. We ask that you would bless these faithful servants with courage and confidence. Remind us that you are in their classroom and that you keep the presence of these people in the classroom too. We ask that you would keep them with a steady hand. We ask that you would give them peace, patience, and balance in all the pressures that they face. Move them into bravery to build structures and systems that are just and that serve all your children. We ask that you would give those who participate in school a delight in children, the ones before them. We ask that you would help them to recognize the sweet ways children are also our teachers. We pray for health and wholeness, for fun and growth, for surprise and amazement, for this school year ahead, for all involved. We pray knowing that you hold us all the way through, and we thank you, gracious God, for your providential and ongoing care, for your Holy Spirit that guides. And we pray for you, for us. We pray together that you would guide and keep us. Amen. So whichever school district you are about to head off into or already have, whether you're an adult or a child or anywhere in between, my hope is that you would know that the school year can be a tiring season, but it can also be such a great time of growth and becoming who God is always calling us to become. I hope that you have a wonderful year, and if you have any needs, anything you would like to visit or talk about or discuss, or if there's anything that I can support you in, I ask that you reach out, and that in any way, if you're ready for it, I can walk with you into this year. My hope is that it's a great one. Stay safe, and I'll see you soon. 'Cause I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.